Lions TV, we are sponsored by Regal Elevators and Lifts Consultants Limited, a company that is owned and operated by a Millwall fan, just like every single one of the sponsors that you can see on the screen right now. If you are going to do a bit of business in 2021, then please keep it in the Millwall family by checking out all of our sponsors' website links in the description below. This is your preview for Saturday's very difficult away trip to high-flying West Bromwich Albion at the Hawthorns. As always, let's start out with the starting 11 that Gary Rowett might pick to start the match. So it seems like a lifetime ago since our first win of the season. Of course, Jake Cooper's late winner at home to Blackpool just before the international break saw us get the first W on the ball. That wasn't really a W, that was. So, going into this game, it's going to be very, very difficult. We're in a good position, of course. We've got through the transfer window without losing Jeb Wallace and signing Shay Ojo, a winger on loan from Liverpool. Last season, he was on loan at Cardiff. Looks like he's had a good career. He's obviously come from very good calibre, and it's going to be interesting to see if he goes straight into the team and where he fits into it. On top of that, Gary Rowett is welcome back this week to full training. Mason Bennett and Ryan Leonard and Sean Hutchinson and Danny Mack are expected to follow them next week. So we're not far off full strength again, which is good because we've got six games in the next 18 days, starting on Saturday, of course, at West Brom. And as I said, this will not be an easy game. What do I think he'll do? Let's have a look at it. Bielkowski in goal. Billy Mitchell, right wing back. Of course, Danny Mack still injured. Scott Malone, left wing back. Murray Wallace, Jake Cooper, Daniel Ballard, fresh off international duty as a back three. I think he'll play Keith Dembeld in a holding midfield duo with Ojo left, Jed Wallace right, and Benik Afobe as a central striker. Good side. Someone tweeted me in the week and said, flat back four, this is our best team. I said, it's a good team, mate. It's not far off his best. But never as long as he's got an O on his arse, excuse my French, is Gary Rowett going to play four at the back, especially away from home, especially against West Brom. So make no mistake, it's going to be three at the back. But looking at that side, it isn't too sad, in my opinion. Okay, let's move on to our opposition. It is the aforementioned West Bromwich Albion. They're one of these yo-yo Norwich Watford annoying fuckers, Fulham, that sort of too good for the Championship but not good enough for the Premier League. They should be a little, you know, bridging between the two, maybe. But let's leave that one for another day. Let's talk about their manager. It is Valerian Ismail. They recruited him from Barnsley after a very good job that he did there. And he's now in charge for their latest push towards the Premiership. And they've had a great start. They've played 5, won 4, drawn 1, and lost 0. And they're currently joint top scorers in the division with Fulham with 13 goals. The one to watch is going to be Alex Mowat. Of course, Millwall were interested in him last year's transfer window, I think it was. We offered him a contract. He was coming to the end of his deal. Didn't take it. Ismail's gone to West Brom and he's taken the former Barnsley skipper with him. And I'd expect him to pull the strings at the Hawthorns on Saturday. He scored 2 goals in his first 4 games. So this is your pre-match prediction. And here we go. We're going to win this game. And let me explain why we're going to win the game. It's because I'm not going on Saturday. So you just know for a fact we're going to win the game. The reason I'm not going, well, it could be twofold. Now, I'll go with the original reason I'm not going. I bought tickets for my favourite childhood film, Back to the Future, well, trilogy, Back to the Future, at the Adelphi Theatre in May 2020, when the football season ended. Of course, lockdown kiboshed that for everyone, and I originally had tickets for a Saturday. A Sunday. They've now given me tickets for this Saturday. So I waited till the fixtures come out, and I thought, well, if it's a home game, I can go straight from the Den to the Adelphi Theatre, which is just not far from Charing Cross. But I forgot to change the tickets and we're West Brom away. I've also been West Brom twice in 4 days a couple of seasons ago. I've been there loads of times. So I'm going to sit this one out. But Kenny and Toomey and possibly some O'Maras will be on Lions TV duty. So you're not going to miss out on any of your content. But as I said, this is your pre-match prediction. And here we go. We're going to win the game by 1-0. And Ojo is going to score the goal on his debut after 14 minutes, to be precise. So that's your lot for this preview show. I hope you have enjoyed it. There will be a fan score prediction at some point, but currently it's 1 p.m. on Thursday and I've had no videos in, so that could be out tomorrow. But if you think you know what the score is going to be, do not be shy to put it in the comments below. Have a good day at the Hawthorns on Saturday. Make plenty of noise for me. Please subscribe to Lions TV. Come on, you Lions.